Today in the grain market, soybeans were higher. That expansion of the position limits just seems to be supporting the market from this point. We kind of had a lower start overnight, and it was a surprise that once the market opened this morning after the pause, it really started to get some legs. Now, the NOPA report came out today at 11 o'clock, and it was much lower than expected, and the lowest really that it has been in the last year and a half. And yet the market still was able to, you know, move higher. I think that tells me that there is a commitment to the long position here, and that is really taking hold here on this first day of the week. I think one thing to remember too is as the long positions, you know, continue to grow, that it could add more volatility to the market. And certainly that does add for more opportunity, but I think that it looks like that's going to be the focus really for the next couple of weeks, certainly until we're waiting for the March 31st acreage report. Now, corn did surge as well. It was up over 10 cents. I think that there's more spec buying coming in and just pushing the futures higher. You know, in spite of the fact that the stock market is also up, making a new high as well. So there's a lot of action in the markets overall. Now, the Buenos Aires grain exchange did cut the crop for corn and soybeans. Not a huge amount, but you know, a significant one. So that also is adding a little bit to the market. But clearly, this position situation is really what's bringing in a lot of buying. And I think that, you know, as that starts to move higher, that's going to just have, they're just going to be adding more and more to the market. And I think that's the market right now has really just been driven by headlines going forward. And today, the real headline is that the position limit change, as we're here in the midpoint of the month of March. Open interest, and we expect option volatility did end a little bit higher on Friday in the, on the corn side. So it looks like today it's going to be higher even more. So, you know, perhaps we're turning that around as well. Now, the wheat was firm. I think futures were lower to start, but it did find some buyers as well. And now it needed just to get a little bit of support and has been following corn and soybeans. Even Kansas City today dropped below the $6 mark, but it recovered and started to gain a little bit of strength. Now, we're going to be looking for acreage on at the end of the month in the spring wheat, but we know that that's really going to be a wild card, and perhaps even that number isn't going to tell the real tale until even much later. So there's going to be plenty of things to be looking at going forward, but clearly headlines are going to be driving the markets in the grains.